Welcome to Inside College Basketball, presented by Progressive Insurance. With you for the next 30 minutes, Adam Zucker, along with my friends Clark Kellogg and Seth Davis. And we are exactly 1 month now from Selection Sunday. Chaos comes in the tournament, but it's been all season. It's a storyline, Seth. Another top five team going down. And when we come back, it's time for our full court press, Valentine style. Will Penn State continue to steal our hearts? How much love will the selection committee show those Cavaliers? And will Sparty fans remain brokenhearted? The guys are on the clock next.
Inside College Basketball, presented by Progressive Insurance, is sponsored by Jersey Mike Subs, be a sub above. And by Progressive, save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance.
Credit them for maintaining that aggression, even.
And MP throws it down.
Close drive that time by MP. Slice it right.
And MP throws it down.
Close drive that time by MP. Slice it.
It's our team. Let's go to work.
Hi, everyone. Glad to have you with us for round two of the tournament. I'm Forrest Hunt, along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, bringing it to you live here on 2K Sports. And tonight we've got the Florida Gators playing against the Oklahoma Sooners.
And Oklahoma looking to build off what they did in round one. MP, one of their integral components. We'll be watching him closely.
For both teams, with the first step in the rearview mirror, we'll see who steps up. Screen by MP. Barrett into the lane. MP outside. Banked in off the glass. One thing that's been clear with MP ever since signing day, he goes his own way, and he's in control of his own fate.
Talking with MP, you can tell he's a real guy, authentic. Whatever path he chooses will be up to him, though. No outside influence is trying to guide him one way or the other. He's making the call.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Now here's MP. D right on him. Stolen by Diaz. To the inside. Lawson shot's good.
And doesn't take Diaz long to spot the wide open man. He's always ready to exploit the defense's weakness.
Barrett with it. Guarded now by Palmer. Takes the 13-footer. Here's Hawkins. And he jams it with authority. And the Gators with possession. Pass to Bayless. MP with the block.
Alertness pays off with a block from MP. That focus is something scouts are sure to notice.
Now here's MP. Here's Hall. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
Seems to have a knack for hitting guys in their spots. His vision, excellent. And something that many of these young guys are dealing with, Greg, the amount of nerves and anxiety you feel when you're playing the tournament game, it's more than a notion.
It's a pressure you can't prepare for. The upperclassmen should be okay if they've been here before. But for freshmen and first-time tournament players, it can be overwhelming. This matchup between the 1 and the 8 seed, it doesn't feel as one-sided as many do. You really feel like this is anyone's game.
Two shots. Last on the first.
And with the 8 seed and 1 seed dynamic you mentioned, rarely does an 8 seed come in as hot as this one's been.
And you knew one of the top seeds were going to have to deal with them. Still, when you're a number 1 seed, you need to find ways to survive in advance, because that's what it's about this time of year. In the topsy-turvy world of college basketball, you've got to respect the consistency of Florida's program.
Absolutely. Not many schools are as solid as the Gators. That helps them attract premier young talents who can carry them deep into the tournament.
Down low, Lawson, and that comes off the assist by Palmer.
Well, I think this is the start they wanted. Come out and put some points up early. 3 of 4 so far.
Outside Barrett. Outside Norris. MP. There's the screen. Pass to Hawkins. Back to MP. The three is up. The rebound by Mercer. Outside Palmer. And here's Bayless. Shoots a three. Paul grabs the board. Now here's MP. Defended by Bayless. And that one is good. MP.
I like the mindset from MP. Attack the hoop.
The Gators trailing.
Florida is obviously a well-established basketball program. They went 17 years straight with a winning record every season.
Diaz outside. Mercer. And the jam by Mercer.
And he might be small for a center, but boy, can he jump out of the building.
Here's the Sooners with the ball. It was only a few years ago that Florida's incredible streak of winning seasons got snapped.
Yeah, back in 2015, must have been tough to beat that team, but just goes to show you there's no sure things in college hoops.
Now here's MP. 7 points in the game. And it's in there.
Well, excellent decision making that time by MP. Some savvy on display in the two-man game.
Now a timeout called by Florida. Gators making a change here.
Jalen Underwood, Austin Vincent, Floyd Conley, substitution for Florida.
Pass to Palmer. Bayless, Fisher, covered by Fisher.
And Florida's produced its fair share of NBA talents. Recent notables, Al Horford and Bradley Beal, a couple of Gators turned all-stars.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use of the pick to get a great look.
Fisher outside. They set a pick. Pass to Waters. Now here's Bayless. And there is a whistle. That goes on Barrett. That's his first foul. And in addition to their alma mater, Horford and Beal have another thing in common.
That's right. Both were chosen third overall in the draft. And those guys are a real testament to the quality of the Florida program.
Here's Waters. MP grabs the miss. Fires for three, and the Sooners hit again from deep.
Seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off of them during the run.
Now here's Palmer. Fisher outside. Inside, Snow. Palmer, pocket six, over Underwood. Palmer can't hit. Here's MP. He has seven. Pass to Conley. Screen by MP. Here's Underwood from the arc. That one's off, and he starts the game with a miss. They've been struggling here offensively.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Outside Palmer. Here's Snow. Underwood defending. Tries to snap the cold streak. And here's MP. Outside Barrett. To the middle, and he floats it in for an easy two. Credit the assist on that play.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
Just no resistance on the interior.
Outside Palmer. MP with the block. Underwood the screen. MP outside. Pass to Underwood.
Florida foul. Jay Smith. That's his first personal foul. Coming onto the floor for your Sooners. Substitution for the Gators.
To the paint. Here's Hall. And the powerful one-hand slam. they're having trouble stopping this run.
And the more trips they continue to come up empty, the more the pressure builds on them.
That's the end of the first half. Your Sooners, 34. The Gators, 20.
And glad to have you back. Round two coverage of the college basketball tournament. Start of the second half in this one. What grabbed your attention about MP's performance in that first half?
Well, it's a coach's dream to have a star player with that versatile a skill set, contributing in a variety of ways.
And we're only through one half of play. I'm anxious to see what else he does now that he's warmed up.
Diaz from outside, and he's good on the three ball.
And the focus Diaz has at the arc doesn't want to waste any shots or jeopardize his hard-earned three-point percentage.
Takes it from 10. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Pass to Palmer. Bayless outside. Now Diaz. Palmer. They set the pick. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Palmer's so smart and fearless. Seems like he has a knack for baiting defenders into those fouls.
So he gets them both. Here's Barrett. Screened by MP. Back to Barrett. For three. MP up top. And that one hits back iron.
Well, you know, you'd like to see a little more effort there defensively, but maybe they wanted him to take that shot, baited him into it.
Diaz outside. Pass to Bayless. No good there. So the Sooners will take it the other way. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. Back to MP. The screen. The rebound by Mercer.
Boy, he has to put that one away. A solid opportunity gone awry.
Diaz outside. Bayless outside. Mercer right side. And another miss by Florida.
You know, not sure if he's playing to the crowd, but no need for the fadeaway on that shot.
Now here's MP, guarded closely. Now here's Norris. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Outside Palmer. Diaz, covered by MP. Now here's Bayless. He's closely guarded. And plenty of contact on that shot, so two free throws coming up. And there's the whistle. Foul on the Oklahoma Sooners.
Franklin Bayless taking two shots.
And the Gators making a change here. He's off on the second. The Sooners with the lead. And P drives in, out of bounds. Sooners ball as Oklahoma keeps possession. The Sooners making a switch here.
Your Sooners, Javon Bradley.
Here's MP. Nice shot from the wing.
Going old school. MP using the mid-range. That is so tough to defend.
Bayless with it. Outside Palmer. And there's a pick. To the middle. Snow misses.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
You know what? No rebounds, no rings, and they've controlled the boards, and that's what's given them control of this game.
Now here's Bradley from deep, MP, and the Sooners hit again from deep.
A good look there, and he didn't waste it, his second three of the game.
Pass to Snow. Over Underwood. Underwood with the defensive effort.
Ooh, this is turning into a slow start here in the second half. Seems like they left that offense in the locker room. Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
Absolutely. I echo that sentiment. Their offense, their defense. I mean, it's all been terrific.
They set the screen. Here's Waters.
Defensive foul. MP. That's his first personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for the Gators, Brad Waters. Two shots.
Shooting two.
And that one misses. And he sinks the second.
Boy, they came out of the locker room at halftime with a much more physical disposition than they had in the first half.
And that helps, Clark. They've gotten extra trips to the foul line, and they need that to continue if they're going to get back in this game.
Here's Conley. Back to Bradley. Pass to Davidson. Shot clock at six. Here's Wong, covered by Fisher. Wong, no good.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Bayless outside. Fisher. And finished off by Fisher.
Jim Fisher.
Here's Bradley. Here's Conley. Pass to Bradley. Over Palmer, and the shot falls short that time.
I wouldn't say that's exactly his spot now. I mean, and you can see why.
And that one's good. Waters.
They're not as aggressive from the outside.
Coming onto the floor for your Sooners. Substitution for the Gators.
Now here's Diaz, guarded by Barrett. To the inside. Mercer can't hit. One item that stood out, their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it makes it really hard to defend.
Pass to Norris. Back to MP. Shot clock at five. Outside, Norris. From deep, three-point range. Doesn't go that time. And Florida now the other way.
He's had an off game thus far, but his team has been able to pick up the slack and find a way to get it done here.
And it's Mercer off the drive, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
They've been getting it inside at every opportunity and getting results, too.
Yeah, that's a winning formula as far as I'm concerned. They've been the aggressive and far more assertive on the offensive end. And Norris can be really patient offensively. Doesn't mind letting the looks come to him.
Fields covered by Norris. There's a screen. Fields no good. On the wing, Norris. MP outside. Barrett. Kicks it out to MP. Inside. Here's Hawkins. That shot off. Mercer with some nice D. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
MP drives in, and the dunk by MP.
MP, merciless on that attack of the rack. What a throwdown.
And the Gators with possession. They trail by 14. Mercer outside. Pass to Waters. Diaz, here's the pick. Out on the right wing. Six on the shot clock. Lets it go from 11. The tray. Cans it from downtown.
3 points. And the Gators get Diaz so well set up there. His positioning, the timing of the pass, you can tell they are totally in sync.
And as the seconds tick by, this could end up being an upset. You knew one of the big seeds could go out early.
And this team was a popular pick in many brackets. You felt that MP and his team had all the momentum coming in. But anything can happen the rest of the way.
Now Mercer. Lets it go. Off the mark. Had a chance there to trim it to single digits. On the wing, Norris. Back to MP. Launches a three. Rebound by the Gators. And here's Fields. Over to the wing. Now here's Mercer. Diaz outside. Pass to Waters. The third shot of the possession finally falls for them.
That kind of energy and hustle on the glass usually produces good results.
Now here's MP. He's guarded closely. Norris with it. Screened by MP. Norris's shot is off.
Yeah, you know what, guys? He's not very effective from that spot. He's got to put some work in there.
Here's Fields. No good on the three. So it's Oklahoma now. MP with it. And so the Oklahoma Sooners have won and will move on.
They really earned this victory tonight. The job isn't done yet, but they're still going to enjoy this one. That was a heck of a win.
You have to point to the play of MP leading the way for this team. They secured the win, and that's all they care about as they make their way out of the first weekend and live to play another game.
And so that concludes our presentation of College Hoops. For Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, I'm Forrest Hunt saying thanks for joining us and see you next time for round 3 of the tournament.